What does candy and the Easter Bunny have to do with the resurrection of Jesus Christ? Absolutely nothing. Recently, a film was released called The Case for Christ. It was based on the outstanding best-selling book by author and former atheist Lee Strobel. He was a Chicago Tribune journalist who set out to disprove Christianity, traveled the world in an effort to do so. It took him 2 years. He did meticulous research. He interviewed the world's top historians, theologians, medical experts while examining the crucifixion and the resurrection of Jesus. Disappointed because he accumulated so much evidence supporting the Bible and none to refute the claims of Christianity, 2 years later now, he sat in his office one day, and a coworker said to him, "Lee, when is enough evidence enough evidence?"
One of my heroes was C.S. Lewis, a man who began as a skeptic, much like yourself. At the end of his journey, you know what he said? He said, "If Christianity is false, it's of zero importance. But if it's true, there's nothing more important in the entire universe."
Many historians outside the Bible quoted about Jesus, including Josephus. They talked about his followers. They wrote about Pontius Pilate, key events and places. They wrote about the crucifixion, including the solar eclipse occurring for 3 of the hours Jesus was on the cross. They wrote about a great earthquake and, of course, the persecution of countless disciples of Christ. Those who are open to the truth can research for themselves. You'll learn about the early dating of the New Testament documents compared to other ancient literary works. You'll learn about overwhelming archaeological evidence, hundreds of fulfilled prophecies listing specific details about Christ, and of course, plenty of eyewitness testimony, not to mention the thousands of people through the centuries willing to die for the faith. In fact, did you know that James, the half-brother of Jesus, was a pillar in the early church and was martyred for his faith? But up until the resurrection, he was a skeptic. The Bible says even his own brothers didn't believe in him. What changed? In 1 Corinthians 15, verse 7, it says, "Jesus appeared to James in person, one-on-one." In Galilee, Jesus appeared to over 500 people at the same time. And we know there's no such thing as a mass hallucination. Who could ever have manufactured such an intricate story? The Bible, the gospel, it's a masterpiece combining thousands of years of historical events written by at least 40 different authors on 3 different continents, including prophecies in perfect and specific detail. Who could have created and ensured the carrying out of such an elaborate plan years in advance? It had to be God. Jesus said to them in the Gospel of Luke, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise again from the dead the third day, and that repentance for forgiveness of sins would be proclaimed in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." That's in Luke chapter 24. Examine the evidence and believe. I'm David Fiorazzo. God bless you and happy resurrection season.